Taking a look today at five of the more recent Marvel Legends Spider-Man figures. We've got Jessica Drew Spider-Woman, the Elektra Daredevil, Ben Reilly Spider-Man. We've got the recent kind of 2021 Miles Morales, and Chasm, a relatively recent villain as well. So all of this is a very modern wave for Marvel Legends. They are not 1960s comics. It's all pretty recent years that these figures have made their debut in the comics, and that's what these are based off. Let's go look at the packaging and share the UPCs first, and then we will get into each of the figures, measure the scale, and show you exactly what is going on. So Jessica Drew on the back, looking pretty good. You don't get much text on the back there, but if you want a freeze frame, that's what you get. And her UPC is there. Front of the box, pretty plain, just a shot of her there. And of course that Spider-Man logo, very nice, bright kind of coloured card out there with the orange, pink and purple running throughout the entire bunch. Ben Reilly Spider-Man gets pretty much the same, that kind of classic Spidey logo in the same background. And of course a shot of him there. On the back, a piece of text if you want a freeze frame. And just a short digital render there of Ben looking great. And his UPC, should you need it, is there. Let's get through the rest. We've got Miles Morales looking pretty good again in this 2021. I think it was Spider-Man Miles Morales number 30 or so, around that time that this look debuted. Not an easy one to pull off, but I think Hasbro have done a fair job. So some text there if you want a freeze frame. And a UPC. Neil at the end, we'll get Chasm. Again, a relatively recent villain to me anyway, but there we go. There's the details there. And on the front of the box, just again, another shot of him. Love the dark card art with the purple. It is really a standout card, that's for sure. And his UPC is there. And nearly at the end, near there, the Elektra. Elektra Nachos Daredevil, looking absolutely so cool. Such a great design for her. Looking really, really good. And again, some text on the back. And her UPC. So, let's dive in. And Miles is probably the most unusual of the lot of them in terms of his costume being just not quite what you would expect, a la this. So the Miles from recent years, it's quite a change from the suit and the design. He feels much smaller, much shorter in this Miles design overall. We seem to have a bit of missing here in the design. The design has a little bit of his flesh around his ankles on these sneakers. So it's kind of like leggings that stop at point. Then you've got the leg and then these little Miles sneakers that he's got. So it's missing a little bit, but it is not an easy suit for Hasbro to capture and do, that is for sure. It is quite a weird one. We've got a nice embossed Spidey logo on the top and his little kind of, very like Elektra, the mask over his mouth tied at the back. And again, we get a raised Spidey logo on the back and we get the leg print running down and these nice chunky, funky little trainers, which don't look too dissimilar to the comics, really. They look pretty good. Yeah. It's the unusual kind of top that he's got. It's just, yeah, it's a kind of different look, but it is what it is, and Hasbro have tried pretty fairly to capture it. Now, Miles comes with a couple of swap-out hands, so you can have two thwips, if you would like, and you can have two fists, if you'd like, which is a nice combi. In terms of Miles' height, he stands from head to toe, just under 6 inches there, a quarter away from it, or about maybe 15 centimetres tall, so just a little bit under the usual 6 inches. But in terms of articulation on him, you can see we've got a ball joint on that head, so that allows a little bit of range of motion and movement. You can just see his nose and his mouth underneath there. We've got a ball joint up at the top of those arms with a red pin on it, and this big baggy suit. Down to a single joint at the elbows on this big baggy top, and then swivel on the wrists and back and forth. You've got an ab crunch up inside there, inside that top, and that gives you a little bit of movement and a kind of waist articulation, really. Yeah, it's the upper ab crunch that you're turning on that one. You've got pins up at the top of the legs, you've got thigh swivel, double joints at the knees, and down to rocking ankles.
and peg holes there too. So pretty good. Look, like most of the figures here, he's pinless. So it's a nice touch to see that on some of these. That is for sure. So yeah, an unusual Miles, but not the strongest one for me of this wave. Let's go look at Chasm. He's looking pretty nice. He is not pinless, but you can see the differences immediately on him. He's using an older style body, but still a great one nonetheless. Pretty much all black suit. There's very little detail apart from the line across the boots. And then the colour starts up at the top of the chest with his logo. We get a great butterfly joint up at the top there, painted really well, giving a really good kind of bend for poses. He's got two electric little blasts that come with the figure, which you can wrap around the forearms if you want. And underneath, they've got that kind of stain on these Black Widow-esque little web shooters or whatever they are that give that electric shock aspect. Very nice. Do like that. It's quite a striking figure in hand. It's sculpted on the face, which is nice. It's a little bit raised off that color. And then with this kind of almost like paint running down the figure, there's a nice touch to it. It's a nice standout Spidey villain on your shelf. And again, this little electric-y vibe that's on these wrists. I don't know exactly what they're for, but they look good. Pins on this guy, and unlike Miles, double joints there. But other than the butterfly joints, pretty much the same. Not dramatically different, I think. Yeah, pretty much the same. The only addition here is we get a boot cut on that figure, and that's pretty much it, and a waist swivel. So other than that, roughly the same in articulation, but still a solid figure nonetheless. A lot more range of movement on his head, just because of the style and design. So you get plenty of range of motion and movement. Moving on, let's go look at Spider-Woman. She comes with two swap-out hands. So you can either come with flat wall-crawling hands and a fist, and that's your swap-out options basically. So she will have either two wall-crawling hands, so it's tiny against my big fat thumb here, as opposed to the fists. So it's up to you what you decide. Nice little bit of paint on the back there too. She's looking pretty good, and this appears to be, and we'll bring in the more recent Skrull Queen, it looks to be the exact same head, and I think it is. Yes, it is. So they've reused the recent Skrull Queen hair and head, and they've plopped that onto this more recent body for the Jessica figure. But it's pretty much the same figure as such. So there's not a great deal of difference between her and this sculpt as such. She doesn't have the little pieces under the arms for the wings. But other than that, all of her paint is up at the top, on the chest, and around the arms, obviously. And again, a more recent style of Jessica Drew than we've had for other figures. She certainly goes to the gym, that is for sure. Does not skip leg day. And yes, nice little effect on the leg. Looks pretty good. And articulation-wise for her, she's actually not too shabby. Doesn't have the butterfly joint up at the top of the arms, but she does have a ball joint up there. Thigh swivel for the bicep, double joint at the elbows. It is pinless up there, which is quite nice. And swivel on the wrists, upper ab crunch, and pins up at the top of the legs. Thigh swivel, double joints, as I said, pinless, and down to rocket ankles. Still a good-looking Spidey. She looks good. She's just got a nice head sculpt. It's not dated yet, and it's a nice modern design for her. So there you go. Spider-Woman's looking pretty good. Elektra Nachos is looking fabulous. A real standout figure from the wave, I think, and likely the most popular. This is an all-new figure, all-new sculpt, all-new design, and it's looking fab. She comes with a two Psi, which she holds pretty well, and she's got one hand which allows you to grip that just a little bit tighter. Got the Daredevil logo on the chest and a movable belt for posability, which moves up and down with this kind of loincloth piece, beautifully swirled around and kind of tidied into the figure, which looks really nice. It's got a real dynamic kind of flow for it. She's got these big MC Hammer pants on, and this goes over the buttocks. Again, a nice swoosh to the back there. It's really quite nice the way this dynamic kind of pose is done. It looks very good indeed. Let's get a close up of that face. Because we've got some nice sculpting underneath there. And this scarf is removable. This mask is removable. We can take that off. I'll show that in just a second. Her hair is dying to, I think, just break. Because if you look underneath there, it's a very thin piece actually of plastic that's attached to the head. So just be careful you don't yank on this pigtail too much. But it looks fab in the double knot all tied up. Kind of wild actually. And if I pop that off, if I can, there we go. You can see underneath. And I'll pop it back on. You can have her displayed as such. Personally, I don't think she looks as cool as she did with the mask on, but you do get that option. Buy a second, why not? So yeah, nice little addition for Daredevil. Looking very good indeed. So she's got plenty of range on that ball joint. Quite a bit of movement going on for her. You can see the ball joint up at the top of the arms. It's all pinless, which is nice. Double joints at the elbows, always good on a female figure. And you can see the swivel and the back and forth on the arms. Nice bandages on the arms too, I might add. Belt also looks really good. No extra paint on it, but nice buckles and belts, the way it's designed with the ripples and so forth. We've got an upper ab crunch. And then underneath, standard stuff, pins up at the top of the leg, thigh swivel, double joints at the knees, nicely done and cut there. I think that's a boot cut. Yes, there is. There is a boot cut. And down to rocking ankles and peckles, all solid. Nachos is very, very cool indeed. She's probably one of my favorites of the figure. But I have to say, Ben O'Reilly won out for me. He's just something about him. Now, his eyes are definitely a little bit too big for me, and certainly compared to some of the artwork for the figure, it's just a little bit too nuts, but something about it I really like too. It's just kind of nuts. I love it. You get two swap out hands for Ben, basically one thwip, one wall crawling, and in his hand at the moment is one two fists. So it's a kind of mix, mishmash mash of both. But I really do love the webbing on this. The way this has been pulled off is very, very good indeed. And again, we've got a nice butterfly joint underneath there, which makes it really, really solid. And it's pinless too. So again, pretty much all the way. Plus, we've got that New Year vows little toe on him too. So it's looking exceptionally good. Thigh cut, double joints in the knees, thigh swivel. We've got a very good ab crunch on that Ben, so all the way down, let me pull that back for you, and then all the way up, so you get quite a bit of range of movement and motion. You'll get some good Spidey poses out of this guy. Definitely one of the stronger ones of the wave. So between him and Elektra, I'm loving it. Very cool indeed. Just a nice muscular build on him. I can't remember the body they've used. I think it is the Renew Your Vows Spidey. It must be with the toes, but it just works really well. Lots of nice ripples and flesh and muscles, the way it kind of works well with the body. It's a nice, not too big, but not too lean, muscular kind of build for Spidey. And it just works really, really well. I think this is a winner. Very, very good indeed. And with the butterfly joint, obviously, you've got a bicep swivel and a ball joint at the arms and double joints at the elbows. Nicely all done and tidied. Especially with all that webbing, which is apparently quite hard to do in the hands. Dwight and Ryan and the others mentioned at San Diego Comic Con. I did not know that, but there you go. So all in, Ben's a really, really standout figure. Particularly good and Elektra. The others, definitely solid. They are a good bunch of figures. But they might not all be for you. So hopefully this video helps you in your buying decisions. And it gave you a little bit of a look at these figures. But that's it for me, Ben, and the crew. We'll see you for more videos coming up soon.